Racing Against Time for Students in Pathology and IQ is equal to UQ. The question that we omit is our university question. I shall be continuing with the pancreas and gallbladder. Gallstones. This question has been asked innumerable times and this is one of the certain questions for us. Secondly, it can be a specimen, it can be a spotter, and definitely a source of viva questions. In this topic, I shall be dealing with the following subheadings. On the screen, I am finding two different sets of pictures. One, I am finding multiple stones, and then the stones have got multiple flat edges, which we call as faceted. Also, the color is somewhat varying from brownish to yellowish brown. And the second one, it is more solitary, a little rough. It has got a lemon yellow-like tinge, a cholesterol stone. We'll have it in mind. We'll come back to it. The types of stones. So look at the picture first. Now, the plethora of stones that we can get. So multiple stones, they are pale. And this again, I find that there is some kind of a radiating appearance which can be seen. So this is probably one calculus. In this one, I'm finding that there is a central nidus and again there has been deposition. So I repeat, there is a central nidus. Around this, there has been more and more deposition. Something like a pearl and an oyster secretion. So this we will be having in mind for the pathogenesis, the various types of stones. But what should we write in the exam? The gallstones can be divided into pure stones, mixed stones, and combined stones. Pure stones, mixed stones, and combined stones. Pure stones are mostly cholesterol, 90%. The other are calcium bilirubinate, calcium carbonate. So these are all the pure stones. Cholesterol, calcium bilirubinate, calcium carbonate. Mixed stones mean when there is more than one of these components, at least two or even three are present, it is called a mixed stone. Then what is a combined stone? A combined stone is one which is made up of a nidus and a shell. Nidus means the central core and the shell. A mixed stone can be the shell and a pure stone can be the nidus or vice versa. When it is present like this, it is called a combined stone. So there is a pure as well as a mixed component present. I repeat, please write this one, pure stones, mixed stones and combined stones. Cholesterol, calcium bilirubinate and calcium carbonate. What are the risk factors for the gallstones? Age, 40. Normally it is mentioned as fat, fertile, female of 40. Pregnancy or the oral contraceptive use can be there. More common in certain countries such as Mexican Americans, etc. Rapid weight loss after bariatric surgery can also lead to gallstones. Hemolytic anemia and infections we shall have in mind for pigment stones. Diabetes mellitus, obesity. So these are the factors, the risk factors which are involved in the formation of gallstones. Fat, fertile, female of 40 is usually given as a history. This is a picture that we should bear in mind in pathogenesis. Now, this is the ultimate gallstone that we are getting, a cholesterol stone. There are generally two methods of growth. My zoology professor used to say, there will be two methods of growth of any substance. One is called growth by accretion. Accretion means more and more particulate matter are deposited. That is called growth by accretion. Another one is growth by intersusception. A part of it enters and then re-enters ultimately it balloons out the structure. Take your embryo, for example, it forms from the morula upwards. So there are multiple cells. Ultimately, that is a human body. Two types of growth, the growth by accretion, growth by intersusception. Now come back to the pathogenesis. Cholesterol, usually it is soluble. It is found in a soluble form within the gallbladder. Now what will happen is, whenever there is a supersaturation, supersaturation means it contains more of the material than that is usually dissolved. That is called a supersaturation. That can be one reason. Second one is hypomotility. Whenever there is a stasis, the hypomotility also can lead to the precipitation of the solute. Solute is a substance that dissolves, solvent that is dissolved, and solvent is the one that dissolves it. Accelerated nucleation. So what will happen is, whenever there is more of a mucin gel or a stasis, the cholesterol gets precipitated. Initially, it is in the form of small particles, and then this acts as a nucleation around which more and more material can be deposited, from which we will be getting the cholesterol crystals. Mucus hypersecretion plays an important role in the cholesterol crystal formation, and ultimately we get the gallstone, the cholesterol gallstone. So you people will have to explain this. One is supersaturation, two is hypomotility, third one is there is a nucleation, further growth by accretion, and these can be precipitated by hypersecretion of the mucus. So cholesterol crystals are formed, ultimately you get the cholesterol gallstone. This you people must write in the pathogenesis. And between this picture we had seen, the cholesterol stone is usually solitary or few in number, whereas the pigment stones are multiple. They are darker, they have got a faceted appearance. The cholesterol varus is pale yellow. It is round or ovoid, and it is radiolucent. The difference between the stones. How do I remember all this? Now, coming back to the pigment stones, as I mentioned, they are multiple. They are small, rarely more than 1.5 centimeters. There are black pigment stones and the brown pigment stones. And sometimes the stones can be greasy. And because of the calcium soaps, they appear radiolucent. This is a table that I would like you people to buy heart. I will not go into the details of it. I mentioned the types of stones. Pigment stones can be calcium bilirubinate, calcium carbonate. There can also be a biliary sludge. Cholesterol is another stone. Where exactly they are located? Most of them are located in the gallbladder, or they can form an obstruction in the bile duct. The method of diagnosis will be either ultrasonography or ERCP, endoscopic retrograde cholangiopancreatography. And most of them will be having either a family history, a history of hemolysis or infections because of stasis. So this particular tabular column, I would like you people to buy heart. Cholecystitis is an inflammation of the gallbladder. Here I am showing you the normal gallbladder, the mucosa. It has got a finger-like projection which can be branching. And lower down will be the lamina propria and the muscular tissue. Now what happens here in a case of cholecystitis? There is a lot of inflammation. There is fibrosis. Because of that, the fibrous tissue will tend to pull down the mucosa. So the mucosa comes down, and this is called as a Rokitansky ash of sinus, classical of chronic cholecystitis, which you people must write in your examination. In the next picture, it will be clear. Look at this one, the mucosa that is thrown into folds, and then there is inflammation, there can be fibrosis. Look at the pale tissue over here. These are all fibrous strands, which are pulling down the mucosa, forming what is called as a Rokitansky ash of sinus. Draw this picture. These are the sites of impaction. It can be at the head or the neck of the bladder, or it can be in the common bile duct, or it can be in the ampulla of Vater. And they produce various syndromes, which are again important for you from the clinical point of view. What are the complications of the gallstones? Acute cholecystitis, chronic cholecystitis, cholecystolithiasis, which is a formation of stones again, acute cholangitis, there can be a severe inflammation of the duct or the gallbladder, pancreatitis. Only in the last class I had mentioned, acute pancreatitis can be because of alcohol or gallstones. Sometimes retained secretions can form a pus, empyema of the gallbladder, obstructive jaundice. Fistula can be formed between the gallbladder and the intestine. And sometimes there can be perforation. Please try hard this one. It is very easy. There can be acute inflammation, chronic inflammation, formation of stones, formation of pus and empyema. There can be fistula. There can be perforation. These are the various sites of obstruction. Please remember. Coming to the treatment, one is a diet. So adjust your diet in such a way so that there is no precipitate of a particular material. Second one is surgical. And surgery itself can be divided into either a lithotripsy, breaking of the stone, or a complete removal of the gallbladder, cholecystectomy. And there can be other methods of surgery also kindly go into. In this, interestingly, a fistula is created so that the stone passes into the intestine. Medical treatment will include drugs such as ursodiol. Gracias.